Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Brothers and sisters, I'd like to invite all of us to a new approach to addressing the issue of terrorism. Perhaps one which may be very difficult for some sectors of our societies to accept. And I build my case on a simple statement, and that is, no religion or belief system teaches terrorism. If we take a few minutes just to do a cursory search on the internet of terrorist activities that have taken place in the world today, you'll find that terrorism has hardly spared any religion, nor has it spared any non-religious beliefs, or indeed any other communities. I remember growing up as a teenager, I had this, for some reason, I'm sure it was a justified reason, this very cuddly image of Buddhists and of Buddhism, that these people would never hurt a fly. And yet we see what happens in Myanmar and Sri Lanka. But we don't hear of Buddhist terrorism. And rightly so. Buddhism does not teach terrorism. Buddhism does not inspire terrorism. We hear in the occupied territories of settlers burning down farms and homes and mosques and churches. Yet we don't hear of Jewish terrorism or Judean terrorism. And rightly so, Judaism does not teach terrorism. We hear of the atrocities carried out by Christians in the Central African Republic and other parts of the world. Yet we don't hear of Christian terrorism. And rightly so, Christianity does not teach terrorism. We do not hear of Hindu terrorism when hundreds and thousands through pogroms and other atrocities are butchered in India. And rightly so, Hinduism does not teach terrorism, does not inspire terrorism. And the list goes on and on. And the same thing with Islam. Islam does not teach terrorism. Islam does not inspire terrorism. Yes, there are evil Muslims who have carried out acts of terror which are totally un-Islamic. Any religion that teaches or inspires terrorism is not a religion. And the sooner we stop giving any credence to these evil people by attaching the label of a religion to their evil, the better it will be for us. Because by giving them that label, we are giving them that platform that they seek to legitimize their evil ways. What does the Quran say to Muslims? It tells Muslims that we have made you a people of the middle path. The middle path, not extreme in any direction. And it addresses the Muslims as a select group of people, selected for the benefit of humanity. Why? Because you enjoin what is good and you forbid what is evil. That's what makes us better if we want to compare ourselves to others. The Blessed Messenger Muhammad, peace be upon him, has instructed all of us as Muslims. Man ra'a minkum munkara, whosoever amongst you sees an evil being carried out, then we must change that, we must stop that and prevent that by the use of our hands. If we're unable to do that, then by speaking out against it. And if we're unable to do that also, then we must know in our hearts that that is an evil that is unacceptable to God. So we acknowledge that there are Muslims who are involved in this evil terrorism and the taking of lives of innocents. And we condemn them. And just to address some sections of the Muslim communities who feel frustrated, and at times I've struggled to try and understand their frustration. And I've been challenged myself, as the Muslim Council of Britain and many other Muslim organizations have been challenged. Why do you always rush to condemn terrorism perpetrated by Muslims when others of other religions do not do that? Well, the answer for me is in chapter 4 of the Quran. Verse 135 addresses people who believe. All you who believe, stand out firmly for justice as witnesses to God, even as against yourselves or your parents or your family, whether it is against rich or poor, for God can best protect both. Follow not your lusts, so that you may swerve and move away from carrying out justice and being just. If you distort justice or decline to do justice, indeed God is well aware of all that you do. In a very interesting tradition, a hadith of the Messenger Muhammad, peace be on him, he said, help your brother, unsur akhaka waliman aw mazluman. Help your brother, whether he is an oppressor or whether he is the oppressed. So his companions, his friends, were bewildered by this statement. They could understand helping the oppressed, but helping the oppressor? O Messenger of God, what do you mean by helping the oppressor? We cannot join him in his oppression. And he said, you can help him by stopping him from his oppression. And that is our duty as Muslims. To stop these evil terrorists who misuse the good name of Islam. And others who misuse the good names of their respective religions. To speak out against it. And to know in the depth of our hearts that this is an evil that has no place in the teachings of Islam, or indeed the teachings of faith.